Number question 38 of 39. This one we're, I believe we're going to need to use the law of cosines because we've got angle C and then we've got A and B, but we don't have C. So we've got to find one of the sides. We've got to pretty much find side C is what I would suggest doing. And once we have C, we could use the law of sines to get the rest of the way. Okay, so let's do a quick drawing of the triangle. Label what we got, what we know. So there's an A, there's a C, there's a B. Little A, little C, little B. We know big, the angle is 120 degrees. We know little A is 10 and little B is 36. So we use the law of cosines to find C. So we're gonna use that form. C equals, C squared, but we're gonna take the square root of this side, A squared plus B squared minus 2AB times the cosine of big C. And where does that come from? That's one of our formulas from our sheet, the law of cosines. So C squared equals A squared plus B squared minus 2AB times the cosine of angle C. And then we just take the square root of that, that'll give us side C. Okay, so we put in the things we know. C is gonna be equal to the square root 10 squared, and you could just write 100 if you wanted to, but I'm just gonna put all these, B squared, 36 minus 2 times 10, times 36 times the cosine of 120 degrees. Okay, we'll put all of that in one fell swoop. Start with the square root 10 squared plus 36 squared minus 2 times 10 times 36 times the cosine of 120 degrees. It equals, so it tells us that C should be 41.9 nearest tenth. Little c, 41.9. So now we can take this information, we've got big C and little c, we can start using the law of sines. So sine of C over little c, and again, that'll help us find one angle. Why not sine of A over little a? So what does that give us? That gives us sine of 120 over 41.9 is equal to the sine of A over 10. So multiply both sides by 10. Just put that up here. 10 cancels. So sine of A is going to be equal to this. And again, you'll take the inverse sine of both sides because we want A, not the sine of A, of this. And the inverse sine of this. So we'll just put that all in the calculator and we'll get that A is equal to, go ahead and write it out, inverse sine of 10 times the sine of 120 all over 41.9. Inverse sine ten sine of 120. See how it always puts those parentheses for us? divided by 41.9, probably be good. So that's an angle, 11.92. So A Now, should I look for the other angle? Well, this is why I don't have to. 11.9 is like this little skinny angle here. Since it's an inverse sine, the other one would be over here. This would be 11 degrees, so this is 169 degrees. But you can have a triangle that's 120 plus 169 plus a third angle. No, it's not going to work. So that's why we don't have to look for a second triangle here. But what we do need is we need angle B. That's really all we need so far. We got big A. But what we've done is because angle C is so huge, that's all we can do. So angle B, we can find that one. Now we've got 120 plus 11. We don't need the law of sines or cosines. We just know that there are 180 degrees in a triangle. So that's 131.9. And take 180 minus that. It's going to be what? 48.1. Let me just do it this way. 48.1. So B, 48.1. So let's go ahead and get those entered in. And again, we've already done a check that there is not a second solution. So just make sure we get everything in the right place. It's degrees, 48.1, 48.1, and C is going to be, 41.9. Oops, had that, 41.9. But 41.9 is in, we don't know the units, could be feet or whatever, but they're not degrees. This one's in degrees. Okay, one more to go.